Hi guys, in this tutorial I am going to show you how to dual boot Ubuntu with Windows 10. When you start up the PC, you can choose Ubuntu or Windows 10. For this you need Windows 10 pre-installed PC, a pen drive and internet connection. Don't worry if you don't have internet connection for your PC. You can download from your mobile phone and transfer to your PC.
Open web browser. Search Ubuntu in Google. Click on ubuntu.com webpage. Download the latest version. In my case it is 20.04 LTS. For both laptop and desktop, click on Ubuntu desktop. These are the recommended system requirements. In 2GB RAM also it will run fine. Click on download. And yeah, this will start download. Open new tab. Search Rufus in Google. Click on rufus.ie page. Scroll down. Click on Rufus 3.0 portable version or newer version. It will start downloading. Put both the files in same location. Let's make some space for Ubuntu installation. Click on start. Type disk management. Click on create and hard disk partitions. It will open disk management. In disk management, right click on the volume which you want to make some space for Ubuntu installation. Right click. Click on shrink. I want to make around 50GB for Ubuntu, so I am giving around 51 200 MB. Okay. Unlocated partition is created. Right click on the disk. Click on property. Click on volume. Partition style is GPT. Let's check about our BIOS mode. Click on start. Type system information. Open system information. Look at the BIOS mode. In my case, it's UEFI.
Don't worry about seeing Ubuntu image file name. AMD 64. It will work for both Intel and AMD. Next, open Rufus application. In device, select your pen drive. Click on select. Open the image file, ISO file. Our hard disk is GPT. Select GPT like we seen before. BIOS is UEFI. Click on start. Don't change this. Click on OK. It will ask your USB drive, so make sure you backed up your important files from the USB. Write speed is depending upon your USB drive. Close the application. And restart your system. While restarting, when screen goes off and start again,
keep pressing boot menu key. Most of the cases, it's F12 or F10. If you want to know boot menu key for your particular model, type the laptop model or desktop motherboard model and boot menu in Google to get your boot menu key. Once you enter boot menu, go to USB option and hit enter. In this boot option, don't make anything, it will automatically choose Ubuntu. Yeah, it starts loading files. Two options available. Click on Try Ubuntu. Open Install Ubuntu. Select the language you want to install. Select your keyboard layout or go with the default option. Click on Continue. I don't want to connect internet. Internet option is because updating Ubuntu file before installation. Sometimes it takes lot of time from my past experience. So I'm not going for that option. Select Install Third Party Software. Click on Continue. If you don't want to go with making partitions, select Install Ubuntu alongside Windows Boot Manager. Don't go for Erase Disk option. It will wipe out all your data in your hard disk. If you spend some time for making partition, my suggestion, go with Something Else option. Click on Continue. Here is the free space that created earlier in Windows 10. Select that free space. Click on plus icon. Change the type from primary to logical. Select mount point slash. It's a root partition. File system is ext4. 16 GB is recommended. I am giving around 18,000 MB. Click on OK. Next, we have to create swap partition. Click on free space, plus icon. For this, recommended size is size of your RAM. Some say half size of your RAM. I am giving 4 GB for this. Partition type is logical and use as swap area. Click on OK. Then again, select free space. Click on plus icon. In this, don't change the size. Type is logical. It is also ext4 file system. Mount point is slash home. Click on OK. OK, partitions are complete. Don't worry, there is no tick mark for swap partition. Click on Install now. These partitions are going to be formatted ext4 swap ext4. OK, all are correct. Click on Continue. Select your time zone, name of the PC, and create password. Click on Continue. It starts installing. Wait, it will take lot of time. After installation complete, click on Restart now. It asks you to remove your pen drive. Remove it. It reboot the system and take you to the GRUB boot menu. When PC starts, you see GRUB boot menu. Here you can select Ubuntu or Windows 10. For checking Ubuntu installed correctly, go to Ubuntu. Yeah, Ubuntu open. We successfully installed Ubuntu.
dual boot system is ready. You can choose Ubuntu or Windows 10 when you start up the PC. Ubuntu is beautiful. For first time users, it will take little bit time. Yeah, we skipped earlier updating Ubuntu. Connect your Wi-Fi. Go to left bottom, show application and software, second one. It will update your system. Subscribe to this channel.